The number of bacteria in a certain culture doubles every hour. If there were 30 bacteria present in the culture originally, how many bacteria will be present at the end of a second hour, fourth hour, and nth hour? Okay. So beginning total there are 30 bacteria are there. Beginning at the 30 bacteria are there. ಹಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅವರ್ಗೆ ಈಗ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅವರ್ಗೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕೇ ಆಯಿತು, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅವರ್ಗೆ 120 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇದ್ರ ಡಬಲ್ ಸೊ 36 ಹಾಗೆ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಈಸ್ 30 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ 30 ಆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ R is equal to 2. Okay. Therefore, here T1, T2, T3, T4 and so on here. So, T1 means A only. So, from here to here, it is 1 hour. Okay. From here to here, 1 hour. Therefore, at the end of second hour, at the end of second hour means T3, yeah? Then from here to here it is also 1 hour, yeah? From here to here 1 hour total at the end of third hour, yeah? Okay, again T5 means from here to here it is 1 hour, then from here to this one, yeah? At the end of fourth hour. And sorry, therefore, here we want a bacteria present at the end of second hour. Bacteria present at the end of second hour. At the end of second hour means T3. Okay, it is a T3. Okay, Ilinda Livergo 1 hour another total. But Ilinda Livergo 1 hour, and the Ilinda Livergo effect of second hour, and the T3 in 100 point. Again, T3 to T4 1 hour other, Ilinda Livergo end of third hour. Again, Ilinda Livergo and the end of fourth hour. Okay, so second hour and the T3 100 point. So T3 is equal to AR square, yes. Therefore A value is 30 and R value is 2, so 2 square. Therefore this equal to 2 space of 4, 4 is 12, yes. So 120. Okay, bacteria present at the end of second hour is 120, yes. So similarly at the end of fourth hour means T5, find out T5, yes. So bacteria present at the end of fourth hour is equal to T5 is equal to AR raised to 4, yeah. Therefore 30 into 2 raised to 4, yeah. 2 raised to 4 is 16, 16 into 3, 480, yeah. So total 480 bacteria present at the end of fourth hour. Next, bacteria present at the end of nth hour is equal to T of n plus 1. T of n plus 1. So, therefore, this equal to AR into n. Therefore, this equal to 30 into 2 raised to n. At the end of nth hour, so total number of bacteria present 30 into 2 raised to n. So this is the answer here. If A and G be arithmetic mean and geometric mean respectively between two positive numbers, then prove that the numbers are A plus R minus root A plus G into A minus G. Okay. In this case, the solution is the quadratic equation. the quadratic equation having its roots having a its roots as the given numbers as the given numbers is so x square minus of 2ax plus g square is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation here, where a is a arithmetic mean and g is a geometric mean. You know the formula. Suppose ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 is a quadratic equation. Then the roots are given by minus b plus or minus root of b square minus of 4ac divided by 2a. And the varga samikarana idaga other roots are backup on the formula is what there is. See that formula on the third root. So according to that formula, therefore roots are so x is equal to minus of minus 2a, then plus or minus root of minus 2a square here. Minus 2a square minus 4 into a value 1 and c value is g square here divided by 2 into a value 1. So 2 into 1 here. Minus into minus becomes a plus here. So 2a plus or minus root of minus 2a whole square becomes a 4a square minus of 4 into g square divided by 2a. Then this is equal to so 2a plus or minus root of 4 is a common factor, so write 4 outside here. So a square minus of g square divided by 2a, and a square root of 4 is a 2, therefore this is equal to 2a plus or minus 2 into root of a square minus of g square divided by 2a. Okay, divided by 2. Then 2 power factor here. 2 is the power factor. Then a plus or minus root of a square minus of g square divided by 2a. Then this 2 get cancels here. Then a plus or minus root of a square minus g square is a plus g into a minus of g. So this is a required result here. Okay. So next example here. What will be rupees 500 amount? So in 10 years after its deposit in a bank, which pays annual interest rate of 10% compounded annually. Okay. Therefore, you know the compound interest formula. So amount A is equal to P is the principal amount, R is the rate of interest, and T is the time. So this is the formula. In this case, here P is equal to 500. Principal amount is 500. Then 10 years, T is equal to 10 years. And rate of interest is 10%. Rate of interest is 10% here. Therefore, here E is equal to, so 500 into bracket 1 plus R value is 10 years. 10 divided by 100, rate to T is 10 years. Therefore, this equal to 500 into LCM is 100 years. So 100 plus 10 rate to 10 years. Therefore, this equal to 500, 100 plus 10 becomes 110 divided by 100, this raised to 10 here. Then this 0 get cancels here. So 500 into 11 divided by 10, raised to 10 years. So this is a required amount at the end of 10 years. If arithmetic mean and a geometric mean of roots of a quadratic equation are 8 and 5 respectively, then obtain the quadratic equation here. So in this case, okay, so a is equal to 8 here. Arithmetic mean is 8 and the geometric mean is 5. A is equal to 5. Hence, quadratic equation. Quadratic equation corresponding to A and G corresponding to A and G of roots is so x square minus of 2ax plus g square is equal to 0. Hence x square minus 2 into 8 into x plus 5 square is equal to 0. Hence x square minus of 16x plus 25 is equal to 0. Okay. So this is one method here, and one more method here. So they give an arithmetic mean between two numbers as 8 years. There's a alpha plus beta divided by 2 years is equal to 8. And the geometric mean here, root of alpha beta is equal to 5. Okay. Then I take to this one here, alpha plus beta is equal to 16. And the squaring on both sides here, alpha beta is equal to 25. 8 to this side, 8 to the 16. Squaring on both sides here, squaring alpha beta is equal to 25. Therefore, this is the sum of the roots here. Therefore, S is equal to 16. And product of the roots is 5. Sum of the roots and product of the root here. It is the sum of the root. This is the product of the root here. Therefore, quadratic equation is x square minus of sum of the roots. Into x, then plus product of the roots here. That is equal to 0. Okay, that is x square minus of s into x plus p is equal to 0. So sum of the root is 16 here. Okay, s is a sum of the root here. X square minus of 16x plus, and p is a product of the roots here. So 5. So 25, not 5, 25. So 25. That is equal to 0. Okay, so same answer will get here. You can use this method or this method here. You get the same result here.